and welcome to Dr. Mix. I am going to deconstruct and reconstruct Darude Sandstorm. You guys have asked for it multiple times. I do listen to you. I'm going to use my plugins. I'm going to use my keyboards. And I'm going to do that coming up. Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. I don't know what to do with my hands anymore. They just move senselessly by themselves. Today's episode is brought to you by JRV Audio, the makers of these plugins right here. I am going to use them as well as everything else here. As you can see, I've got my mug right here. I've got my Arturia controller right there. And, you know, let me show you what I actually have done. So, as you know, my Minimoog is my favorite instrument ever, and this particular one has inputs for CV, gate, modulation. So basically it can receive CV gate from the Arturia Keylab 49. What a great marriage, because now I can do this. But then I can switch back here, look, bang, and now CV is controlled by this guy. This is gonna be just perfect. Yes, that sound. So I think that pretty much what's happening is that we have a square wave on top up there. So far so good, right? So what's coming after is a sawtooth, but this sawtooth is one octave below. Actually, I think it's two octaves below, and also a fifth below. It's uncanny, isn't it? Let me try and control it with this one. I think I will have to tune it along with the original one if I really want to nail it. Yeah! So now I have created this track. There you go. So ta-ta-ta-ta-ta. Yes. All right. Let's keep going. Okay, you know what? Let me fast forward this. So all we need to do now is bounce it to audio. Oh yes, the Darude lead with the Minimoog. So let me do a couple of things to this Minimoog, right? I am going to add this delay. Right? EQ this SM8. So let's try and go close to that sound. So definitely less low end. Definitely a little bit more mid. Now it's gotten a little bit too loud. Let me, you know what, I can pull down the gain. And whilst I'm at it, I am going to filter the low end a little bit. Yeah, sounds pretty close now, doesn't it? Next, kick. So for the kick, I am using the Dr. Mix 909, which is available in the link below. So let me play that. Click, record. That will be it. I suspect that the original one has a little bit more punch to it, so let's see what I can do here to make the kick drum a little bit stronger. It is a tad loud, so maybe pull this down a little bit. I want to use the Pultec style HEQ2, that's right. So. Oh-hoo. All right. Ooh, that's a tad too much now. Ooh, solid state tube. I think I like solid state. So before, after. All right. Perfection. Let's go with the next snare drum. All right, tiki, 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 tiki. So it starts right from the beginning. All right, I think that's all we need. Bang. Tiki, 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 tiki. So let me, let's create a ramp for this. Bum, bum, bum. We'll do it like that. See, now, this is one of the reasons why I like Cubase so much. You can do things like this. Put it all the way up and just ramp it from zero. That was so easy, wasn't it? All right. But also, if I remember correctly, we have like a change there. Okay. That one, that becomes, I think it's like a 16, to, like 8 triplet? No, 16 triplet. We need that, which is going to be provided by the hi-hat. Clean up low end. This is something you always have to do. You don't need that low end, filter it out, otherwise it's gonna give you muck. I am going to call the SM8 to the rescue again. Bang. Now let's see if I can get closer to that sound. That's good enough. Next! There you go, claps. I don't want to go nuts about it, but you know, just get close enough. Right. Here it is. Attenuate the low end and brighten up right about there. I like that now. Cut, 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 cut. Cut, 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 cut. Bang. I think we're finished with the drums. Now, let's tackle the bass. For the bass, I have decided to use a Prophet. Yeah. This is from Arturia. I love to use this Prophet. It's got pretty neat sounds. It's pretty cool. Bow, bow, bow. What is it, like a probably square wave? Let's see if I can find anything interesting. Yeah, let's see. I think we're close. Something like that. I think I got it. All right, I think I got the bass. I need to emulate the sound now, mix-wise. Well, for once it's too loud. Here I can turn it down a bit. It's a little bit bow, bow, bow. And I'm not getting enough of that, I think. I think it's pretty close. I think I need a little bit more body. I am going to use the Pultec style HEQ2. Let's see if I can get a little bit more mojo going. Ah, a lot better. So we're getting really, really, really close now. We have this. How I am going to get there with the JP8 by Arturia. I have to do that, you know me. Where am I gonna start? By using a little bit of attack? Maybe using both oscillators? And we're not too far off already. Alright, let's listen to the original one. Fum, 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 fum. All right, you know what? This is probably not powerful enough. What I'm gonna do is I am going to add another synthesizer on top of it. How about the Prophet again? Ah, so sweet. It's not exactly what we need. Let me change this. Perfect. Let me just copy the media cross. Bang. Yes. Just in case that wasn't clear, when I press this button, I go A, B between the original track and what I am doing, right? What I'm doing? No. What I'm doing? The original track. What I'm doing? The original track. It's not too far off. We're nearly there. Done. Next, that sequencer. I am going to use another instance of JP8 just because I love it. Let's see if we get any similar sound to that. All right. That's good enough. So the range has to go up. How close is this? Let's see if I can use the arpeggiation. Okay. There you go. Yes. So, I think it's about time to start mixing this. When you see mix on, it means that we're listening to this arrangement. C1 means that we're listening to the original one. Yeah, so that, you know, keep an eye on that to know where I am each time. So I'm gonna need a little bit of reverb on these two things. EQ on this. It's got a little bit too much honk, so you know what? I need a little bit of that air euphony because it's got a beautiful top end air button, this one. Yes. Now I'm a little bit too loud. Come on. Sounds the same. Let's take care of that snare drum, yeah? Not too bad, actually. The last thing that I want to do in order to give it a little bit of oomph is to use the SEAC. S-E-A-C. There you go. Bang. Let's see if I can get some more punch out of this. Yeah, baby. You can also equalize it. This is super cool. Check this out. Okay, let's compare. right, you know what's coming. Celebration dance with the results of my efforts. Let's do this. And that's done. Well, you know me, I'm going to make this multi-track available and also the mix so that you can play with it and mix it up. But I would sure recommend you to go in the link in the description and check out the JRV plugins because they are really, really cool. I hope you had a good time. I sure did. Please remember to subscribe to this channel if you haven't already. I hope you're making great music. I hope you're staying inspired. I hope you're watching Dr. Mix all the time.